cold mashing, or maybe we should let's call it cold steeping. Let's get into that. I'm Dr. Hans, this is Dr. Hans Brewery, my channel about beer and home brewing. Yes, cold steeping or cold mashing, why should we do that? I normally don't do this, but I have a reason for doing this today. And this is another tool in the tool belt for you to use when brewing beer at home. Normally I would top mash instead. I won't go into top mashing today, but I can link down to a video where I talk about top mashing. We're gonna cold steep this overnight. But don't we need to mash this? No, you don't. This is crystal malt and this is roasted barley. Of course you need to mash your base malt, but I'm preparing for a shake and brew where I will do no mashing. So there will be no like mash to top this up on, if you get me right. During the kilning process of the malt at such a much higher temperature than your base malt, these are like pre-mashed, I wouldn't say that, but the starches should already be converted into sugars, so there's no need for mashing. Mashing can actually hurt it, especially roasted malt, if we're looking for brown malts and up, can actually be more beneficial to not mash at all, instead do like steeping or top mashing, or in this case, cold mashing. And we're gonna get into why we're cold mashing this also. This is 100 gram of crystal malt, light crystal malt, which I had at home. So I added 10 grams of roasted barley just for color for this beer. This is a small batch brewing, this is an 8-liter batch. This is about 10% actually, which is quite a lot, but I'm brewing a lower ABV beer, so I think this will work out. I of course have a grain mill for crushing my grains, but I assume that all of you don't have that, so today I will be using coffee grinder, which I actually are using for top mashing to really get the grains fine. Is this good content? That is a super fine crush, and you should probably not crush it that well, like into a flour, but we will be okay. So I will add this to a jar. The big reason that we want to cold mash this and not just put it in room temperature is bacteria. You have natural living bacteria on malt, like lactobacillus, and then this could actually sour. But if you put this into the fridge, the souring process will go super slowly, and as we're gonna use this tomorrow, ain't gonna be a problem. You can actually make sourdough starter from malt, and yes, I have a video about that also. Let's see how much we should use. I'm thinking like half a liter, maybe it should be enough for this. And the doctor will of course give you all measurements in stones and birds also converted. Thank you. As this is for the shake and brew, let's give it a shake. So put this into a fridge. You don't need to boil it, but you should at least pasteurize it. I will take this up to over 70, like 72. That would more or less instantly pasteurize it. You could pasteurize at lower temperature also, but then you would have to do it at a little longer time span. Why would you want to cold steep or top mash instead of mashing? In this case, it's an extract brewing, so there is no mashing. So this is a way to get the sugars out of the grains. I could have also like steeped them for about 20 minutes at brew day, maybe even shorter, like 10 minutes. But why would you choose to do it like this instead of just putting your grains in the mash? Roasted grains can put out quite some astringency. So this will give you a much like smoother, darker beer if you were to do this with darker grains. I don't think there's so much benefits in doing this with light crystal malts, but from brown malt and up, you can cold steep or do a top mashing. That will give you a much smoother beer that you don't need to condition for a long time to get rid of that astringency, as the astringency never went into the beer at the first place. Nice. But I do go even further into that in my Brew Better Stout video, which actually fits all dark beers. Boom! Okay, next day, almost like 24 hours later, and you can see that it has separated. I gave this a quick shake this morning. Let's see if we got any sugars in this at all. got about 10:26. We have extracted sugars, but it's not very good. I would expect for at least maybe 10:40-ish, even a little bit higher than that. So this is obviously working, but maybe it needs to sit a little bit longer, or maybe you could just add some more grains if you're doing this method. Now you could add all of this, example, just before starting sparging, or you could rinse this off like I'm gonna do. You could also like pour out the liquid and fill up a little bit water and try to like rinse out most of the sugars as possible here. I'm gonna use this as is. We have extracted a lot of color and of course flavor. So this will go into my shaken Amarillo. Have a look at that video when it comes out, or if it's all out already, the good doctor put a card there. How much wort to actually get out of this in a simple brewing like the shake and brew style, which is meant to be simple. If you haven't checked out the shake and brew series, do that right now. Or if this video will fit you better, I don't know, try to click any buttons, or yeah, I tror det räcker så. Doktorns out. Hej då.